So here we are, another day aboard White Pearl and the adventures of the Friendly Pirate. This episode, we head from Carabelle to Tampa Bay, pick up a special guest, and meet some new friends along the way. So here we are, about 50 miles into the Gulf of Mexico, off of a little place called Carabelle in Florida, headed to Tampa. And I've got a very special guest aboard, my personal hero, and very special to me to have him joining me, and I'm very lucky that he was able to come and do this. We had doubts if we were going to make the crossing based on weather. So far everything is fantastic. We were actually warned not to go by the marina that, based on the conditions right now, I think they just wanted some more of my money staying at their digs. So let's go topside and see what we got here. Old man Nygaard. He was feeling a little bit sick earlier and got a little cat nap in, and
doesn't look like he's sick anymore.
Let's take a peek here at what we got.
Oh yeah.
Out to some three deck tech, and yeah, if conditions couldn't be more perfect right now. We are approximately 5-6 hours into a planned 30, give or take, based on progress, but so far the progress has been perfect. We've got maybe 6 to 8 knot winds, and we've got the same course set. We're at about 150 degrees, just cruising. Should arrive in Tampa tomorrow, mid-afternoon, which is good because it is going to pick up pretty nasty tomorrow evening. So we're having to do a little bit of motor sailing, which is unfortunate, but we don't want to get caught out here for the winds that are going to arrive later tomorrow afternoon. We want to be safe in Tampa. So if we had the diesel off, we'd be pulling probably around 5 miles an hour, but we're gaining an extra almost 3 just for having that on. So it stinks to not be able to just sail. Doing a little motor sailing, but we'll take it. Turn the autopilot off.
I'm the autopilot.
And we got the autopilot right here.
Yeah, I'm the autopilot.
So this is my dad. He was able to take the week off, and I was real nervous about this crossing because this is about 200 miles, and that's going to be the longest bit of sea to cross for quite a while. So to do that solo wasn't gonna be the most ideal situation, especially this early while I'm still getting my routine down and skills practiced and all that kind of stuff. So got the man here. Water's beautiful, weather's outstanding. Pretty much couldn't ask for anything better. Maybe a beer. Got some friends to join us. So coming into Tampa Bay, you actually arrive at St. Petersburg first, which is about 30, 40 miles south of the proper Tampa Bay city. So my dad and I pulled into a marina hotel called the Magnuson, which was awesome. And I met some friends down at the pool with a little R&R after the sale. So they invited me up to Tampa Bay proper at a place called Davis Island. And so after I had dropped off my dad and said my goodbyes, I opted to sail up north to Davis Island and found a sweet little anchorage in a cove right by an airport, and spent the next about 2.5-3 weeks in Tampa Bay, having a good time with friends, exploring, doing some night sails, went into the city overnight, did a cool overnight time lapse or a dark time lapse thing of the city, so you can enjoy that, and just had a good time basically doing a lot of nothing. And I think that will kind of be the trend, is going to visit a place and just kind of hanging out for a little while. So that is indeed what I did. Spent a couple weeks there.
What's up, friends? We're having a little pirate adventure with some guys that I met cruising here into Tampa Bay. This is Preston and Devin.
What up?
And we are the three bromigos. So we're gonna go out sailing, maybe pick up some mermaids a little bit later, and go just do it up pirate style. So we got a beautiful sunset coming in. Actually, we'll be able to see that on the way out. So let's get this bitch going. sailing around, and there's all these waves starting to pile up.
I don't know if you can kind of see them right here.
So we decided to turn right into them and take them for a ride. Sipping all the way. You can see the speed jump up when we're on a wave. Just surfing out, you know, whatevs. Should be fine.
So while in Tampa Bay, we had a little bit of an accident coming back one night from the city. So I was having my buddy Preston drive the boat. I was asleep in the V berth from a long day of doing nothing. And so he drove the boat back and everything was fine until we got to the anchor, and it was a total accident. But he backed over the dinghy line that was towing the dinghy. And so that sucked the line into the propeller shaft, which knocked out my cutlass bearing. It destroyed the stuffing box, and there were some other bearing type things that I needed to get done on the propeller shaft. So as soon as that happened, the boat was taking on about anywhere from 3 to 5 gallons an hour into the bilge, and it was not a good situation at all. Calling around different marinas and everything to try to find repairs, I didn't have much of an option other than to go to a place called Tarpon Springs, which was 40 miles north of Tampa. But I had to sail down to bottom of Tampa Bay and then back up without using the motor, which was pretty sweet, because I'll tell you what, when you don't have your motor, you learn how to become a real sailor real fast. All right, thank you for watching another episode of the Friendly Pirates and the adventure aboard the White Pearl. Next episode, we're going to cover the process of getting to Tarpon Springs under sail. Got all kinds of great footage that I'm looking forward to share, so that'll be fun. Look for that as soon as I can get back to some internet access. So until next time, guys, enjoy the story, and we'll see you guys again soon. Take care.